Zoom play date for the kids, Zoom birthday party for your friends, Zoom huddle with your boss, Zoom, 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 Zoom. Zoom fatigue is real. If you are like me and you are on back-to-back Zooms practically at the moment and you are feeling exhausted, it is because virtual interactions are taxing on our brains in a whole new way. And as a result, there is a physical and a psychological exhaustion that goes along with that. So what is actually happening? Well, firstly, you're gonna have to emote more when you're on Zoom because you're in a little box and you're having to perform. And unless you're a trained actress like me from my first career, that is not a natural state for you to be in. So your brain is having to work very hard to amplify your emotions so you can get your point across in a very unnatural environment. Secondly, your brain is trying to establish meaning and emotion from the person or people that you're talking to. So where once upon a time in a real life meeting, remember those, you would be getting lots of juicy, wonderful non-verbal cues from another human being, it's likely that you're not getting those on a Zoom call. So let's say you couldn't see my hands and the shot was just from here, you're missing a whole lot of great information that your brain is designed to decode. So you can figure out, does that person disagree with me right now? Are they connecting with what I'm saying? Are they agreeing with what I've just said? You're not able to establish that easily because you're not getting those non-verbal cues. On top of that, it's likely you're not even getting the verbal cues, the mm-hmm and the aha, because everyone else is on mute when you're talking. And in addition, you're not getting those lovely little things, those sophisticated cues that our brain listens for. For example, a quick inhale of breath when we're talking to someone, which indicates to me that they want to say something, or in a group session that they maybe want to interrupt and contribute in a way. So all of that is causing just that extra effort from that magnificent brain of yours. In addition to that, we've got this level of self-consciousness that's going on. You know, what's in my background? Will one of my kids walk in? Oh my goodness, the adrenaline hit that you get when you see your face come on speak of you. Then your brain has to do something with that, right? So all of these things are adding up to what can be quite an exhausting experience. So what can you do about it? Firstly, please be kind to yourself. I noticed today at 4:30, and obviously I've moved all my coaching clients online, my leadership work, that I hadn't actually moved away from my desk all day. I hadn't even been outside for a breath of fresh air. So please be kind to yourself. Please notice what your patterns are like at the moment, and then perhaps more difficult to do, start looking at where you can set some boundaries. Start looking at where you can actually say no. Now, this is a big topic, I know, but for now, use two of the elements of my framework. One is what's in it for me, and one is what's in it for them. So for example, what's in it for me to say yes to this Zoom meeting? What's in it for them for me to say yes to this Zoom meeting? And then the slightly more challenging question to ask yourself is, what's in it for me to say no? Well, maybe you'll come up with two or three things pretty quickly there. What's in it for the other party, whether that's a client, a stakeholder, your boss, your peers, your team, a family member, a play date for the children? What's in it for them for me to say no? And be prepared to be surprised by how amazingly creative your brain will be around actually what is the gift that you might be giving the other person. And if you're not sure, ask them, what would it be like if we didn't actually have this meeting? Try it out, set some boundaries, start saying no, and be kind to yourself. And as always, if no one else tells you today, please let me be the one to tell you that I am grateful for you. Thank you for letting me be a part of your day, and thank you for being a part of my world.